Hello friends and welcome to our forget-me-not service. As we know, we are unable to gather together in our lovely Farleigh Gardens again this year, and we are very grateful to you for joining us online and for your ongoing support for Farleigh Hospice. We are here today because we are remembering those we love. All of the music and readings selected for today have been chosen to uplift you and bring you comfort as you remember those you love. Our hope is that you will know that you are not alone, even though we are still apart. Thank you for sharing with us today.
It's okay. It's okay to miss them. It's okay to say their name. It's okay to cry.
It's okay to laugh. It's okay to breathe deeply. It's okay to smile when you think of them. It's okay to function.
It's okay to have days where you can't. It's okay to be angry. It's okay to be thankful. It's okay to love again.
It's okay to remember. It's okay to hope. It's okay to be honest. It's okay to trust again.
It's okay.
It's okay.
It's okay.
Yeah. everybody. I'm Sandra from the Yo-Yo Project, and I'm going to read you a story today called The Invisible String. To the children of the world and their magic strings. Liza and Jeremy, the twins, were asleep on a calm and quiet night. Suddenly, it began to thunder and rain very hard. Thunder rumbled until it got so loud that it woke them up. "Mummy, Mummy," they cried as they ran to her. "Don't worry, you two. It's just the storm making all of that noise. Now go back to bed." "We want to stay close to you," said Jeremy. "We are scared." Mum said, "You know we're always together, no matter what." "But how can we be together when you're there and we're in bed?" said Lisa. Mum held something right in front of them and said, "This is how." Rubbing their sleepy eyes, the twins came closer to see what Mum was holding. "I was about your age when my mummy first told me about the invisible string." "I don't see a string," said Jeremy. "You don't need to see the invisible string. People who love each other are always connected. It is a very special string made of love." "But if you can't see it, how do you know it's there?" asked Lisa. "Even though you can't see it with your eyes, you can feel it with your heart. And you know that you are always connected to everybody that you love. When you're at school and you miss me, your love travels all the way along the string until I feel it tug at my heart. And when then you tug it right back, we feel it in our hearts," said Jeremy. "Does Jasper the cat have an invisible string?" Lisa asked. "She sure does," said Mum. "And best friends like me and Lucy?" asked Lisa. "Best friends too." "How far can the string reach?" "Anywhere and everywhere," said Mum. "Would it reach me even if I was a submarine captain deep in the ocean?" asked Jeremy. "Yes," Mum said, "even there." "Or a mountain climber?" "Yes, even there." "Or a dancer in France?" "Even there." "A jungle explorer?" "Even there." "How about an astronaut in space?" "Yes, even there." Then Jeremy quietly asked, "Can my string reach all the way to Uncle Brian in heaven?" "Yes," said Mum, "even there." "Does the string go away when you're mad at us?" "Never," said Mum. "Love is stronger than anger. And as long as love is in your heart, the string will always be there." "Even when you get older and can't agree about things, like what movie to see, or what game to play in the back seat of the car, or what time to go to bed?" "Oh, that's right, you two. You should both be in bed." And with that, they all laughed as Mum chased the twins back to their beds. Within a few minutes, they were asleep, even though the storm was still making some loud noises outside. As they slept, they started dreaming of all the invisible strings they have, on all the strings their friends have, and their friends have, until everyone in the world was connected by invisible strings. And from deep inside, they now could clearly see that no one is ever alone. And we all have our very own invisible strings to our loved ones. Thank you for listening.
There is a short piece of writing about grief that says, "Grief, I've learned, is really about love. It's all the love you want to give but cannot.
All of that unspent love gathers up in the corners of your eyes, the lump in your throat and in your chest. Grief is just love with nowhere to go. Of course, we know that neither grief nor love are simple, but for me there's something both simple and profound in these words. All of us gathering today are here because we have both loved and lost. And I wonder if at times it may feel as if that love has left you. Those beautiful little flowers, aptly named forget-me-not, are a simple reminder that the seeds of love that we sow into this life will continue to grow and blossom and flourish long after we have left this life. They are symbolic of the fact that even though this life is temporary, love does not and cannot fade. And so, as we remember those we love so very much, may you know that love is for you, it is with you and around you always.
Thank you.
We talk about them because we are proud. We talk about them because they deserve to be remembered. We talk about them because even though they are not physically with us, they are never far from our mind.
We talk about them because they are a part of us, a part that we could never ignore or disown.
We talk about them because we love them still and always will, forever.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.